Hey, welcome to What's the FIC, where two nerdy librarians, Gina and Meg, discuss everything from literature to movies, gaming, education, anime, manga, and more. All your favorite things you get geeked about, we talk about. Plus, we give you tips on all the latest free resources from the library. So, let's get into the FIC of it.
Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to What's the FIC, hosted by Meg and
Gina.
Today, we're going to be doing our holiday episode, seasons, readings, and more. So we hope you guys are enjoying your upcoming break. We know that Christmas is right around the corner, or if you celebrate Hanukkah or Kwanzaa, all those things are coming up or have already happened by the time you listen to this episode, of course. But we're going to just talk about some of our favorite holiday movies, holiday books, of course, and maybe we'll recommend some things, like some events happening at your local libraries in Augusta-Richmond County, okay? So let's get started.
All right. So this time we're going to do things a little different. Jump into the movies first, Meg. Let's do
yes,
that first.
Yes.
So I think that a great movie recommendation for this holidays is This Christmas. Mm-hmm. If you haven't had an opportunity to see it, This Christmas is about the Whitfields. And how all the siblings come home after, you know, all these years, mm-hmm. and they bring a little bit of baggage with them. So as they're putting up their Christmas tree and everything is hung, all these secrets and family things start to come out. And how are they going to really come together mm-hmm. and understand the true meaning of like family and Christmas? So it's great. It's got a lot of yes. heavy hitters in it, mm-hmm. Like Idris Elba. And I think that anybody who, you know, want to get into Christmas spirit should definitely yes. check out This Christmas for sure.
Yes, I totally agree. I love that movie. I think every year, if not every other year, mm-hmm. we put it on usually when we have family over the house. So my family mm-hmm. does. We always put on This Christmas. That's on the rotation. So that's a good one for sure, for sure. Mm-hmm. All right.
So well, you know.
Yes.
For me, mm-hmm. what's on my rotation, right?
Yes.
It's the Peanuts.
Of course. Of course, because last time you said it was the Thanksgiving special.
But Peanuts celebrates every holiday, and this is uh-huh. no different, because Peanuts Christmas special is another masterpiece, okay?
Yes.
I love Charlie Brown. If you guys don't know already or can't mm-hmm. tell, I adore Charlie Brown for every yes. season. And it's my tradition to watch the Peanuts Christmas special. So a quick synopsis is, Christmas is almost here, which means ice skating, Christmas carols, and sparkling lights everywhere,
yay.
Even on Snoopy's doghouse.
Oh.
Everyone is enjoying the holiday celebrations except Charlie Brown.
Of course.
So can the Peanuts gang help Charlie Brown discover the true meaning of Christmas? You're going to have to watch it to find
yeah.
out.
I mean, you can't miss this thing. It comes on every year on the channels that you normally would see.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the football game is on. Well, before the football game comes on, Charlie Brown special yes. is playing earlier in the day. So you have the chance to watch it. So definitely go watch that on Christmas Day, and probably before then, because it's going to be playing every day, if not every other day.
Or check it out from us.
This is true. You can check it out from the local library. Yes,
and put it on repeat. Yes.
This is true. This is true. Okay, so that leaves us to another Christmas classic. A lot of people may know this if you grew up with A Christmas Story. So, A Christmas Story, you know, it's a kind of classic movie. And a lot of people remember the scenes from, I guess, the child who goes and they dare him, I think, to lick a light pole or something, and his tongue gets frozen and stuck to that, and he's just out there like, ah, you know, a lot of people that would crack them up. But of course, if you love A Christmas Story, you can find that sometimes that plays on TV as well, or you can check that out from your local library, because we have plenty of copies of it. So definitely check out A Christmas Story. But you know what, that leads me to my favorite classic Christmas story.
Oh, what is that?
Home Alone. Okay.
Oh.
Home Alone is that movie. Okay. So basically, it's about Kevin McAllister. Everybody knows he's kind of a troublemaker, you know. And his parents go on, his parents and his family, basically, his whole family goes on Christmas vacation, but he gets accidentally left at home. So now he's having the time of his life, living it up, no parental supervision at all. And all of a sudden, these two guys try to break into his parents' house. These two burglars are coming in. So now he has to try to defend his home. So funny, quirky antics happen. You see all the clever ways that he's able to, you know, make sure these burglars don't, you know, get anything from his parents' home. But it's a lot of fun. I think a lot of people can enjoy that, whether you're old or you're young. So that's a classic to me, I should say. Any of the 90s kids.
Yes, definitely. I definitely agree. Like, I remember, I've seen all of them because there's more than one. But definitely, especially this time of year, just all the little antics and everything that happens. So good.
Yeah. Actually, the funny thing about this is I've actually watched the second film, Home Alone 2, more than I've seen the first one. And I actually remember that plot line a lot better than... Yeah, and it might have been because my parents had it on VHS tape, giving our age away there. but yeah, so that's a good one. That's a good one. Another one of my favorites, actually, too, because I used to watch this, I think, every year in school. Like, my teachers would play this because it was a pretty, you know, neutral, safe movie to play. Christmas with the Cranks.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so that's one with Tim Allen. So a lot of people might know the actor Tim Allen from Home Improvement or, you know, him as the, I think he's the voice of, is it Buzz Lightyear?
Yes.
Yes, yeah, yes. Buzz Lightyear. Yes. Okay, cool, cool, cool. Yeah, so yeah, Christmas with the Cranks is about this family, the Cranks, and basically their daughter is off in college somewhere. I think she's in college. Don't quote me on that. but basically tells her parents that she's not coming home for Christmas. And so her mom is just like, you know what? Let's just skip Christmas. We usually do all this decorating and putting out the lights and these grand Christmas trees just for her, really. And it's just like, you know what? Now that she's kind of grown and on her own, we're just not going to do it. But lo and behold, all of a sudden, their daughter calls and says, Mom, Dad, I'm coming home for Christmas. And so now, after they have planned not to do any Christmas dinner, they've planned to do no decorating, buying no gifts, nothing. All of a sudden, her parents, Luther and Nora, have to spur of the moment, try to get everything together on, like, I think it's either a couple days right before Christmas or the day before Christmas, and try to set up everything, buy the ham from the store. And of course, a lot of hijinks ensues with this tale too, because they just have a good old time trying to fight people in line for the last turkey at the grocery store that she knew she should have bought weeks ago. So yeah, that's a good one. Christmas with the Cranks.
I've never seen it before. Oh. I'm going to tell you right now, if I was in their position, she would have came home to not a one light up there. It wouldn't have been a light. There wouldn't have been no Christmas ham, nothing.
Nothing. Wow. But I don't blame you. That's a lot of last minute, because they're trying to compete with all these other people who've got like these extravagant decorations on their yard and in front of their house, and I'm just like, that's a lot of work. That's a lot of work. Yeah.
Alrighty then. So we're gonna dash on in to our holiday books here. Yeah, I know.
I like that. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. So, speaking of traditions, I think most people, whether you know where it comes from or not, twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. That is The Night Before Christmas by Clement Clark Moore. So if you didn't know where that came from, now you know.
Yes.
And it's a famous Christmas poem that was published as A Visit from St. Nicholas. Mm-hmm. And of course, the work is credited to Clement Clark Moore, and it's been inspiring kids and captivating their minds as they prepare for Santa and all the reindeer for many years. I remember the full book And you can, of course, get this book at ARCPLS. And there are a lot of different versions of this book.
Yes.
Because remember, the original is a poem, but there's so many picture books that have been so beautifully done over the years. Mm-hmm. But the fun fact is that it was originally published. It was originally published in 1823. Mm-hmm. And of course, Clark Moore, or Clement Clark Moore, is the one who's credited with it. Apparently he wrote it for his children because he liked writing poems for his kids. And that was just kind of like his way of getting them excited. So I just thought that one was really perfect and really sweet.
Yeah, definitely. That's a good bit of history to know, because I had no clue that was inspired by his own children. So that's pretty cool. Yes. So another good book you can pick up for all you parents out there or children, we have Bear Stays Up for Christmas by Karma Wilson. I just want to say I love this series because there's multiple books about Bear staying up or, you know, doing something. And he's just a cute little, well, he's not little, he's a big guy, he's a bear. But the stories are always really cute. But basically, Bear is sound asleep, as bears do, you know, hibernating during the winter time. Mm-hmm. And he's determined that he's going to stay awake for Christmas. Because, you know, usually at nighttime, you're like, it's only a couple hours on Christmas Eve until, you know, the day of. And you kind of want to stay up to 12 so that you can wish all of your family and friends Happy Christmas or, you know, Merry Christmas. So he's like, I'm going to stay up no matter what. So his friends, other little animals out in the woods, they start making mint tea, singing carols, finding the right Christmas tree. They do everything to make sure that Bear stays up and active. He makes food and presents for his friends, not noticing that Father Christmas has also come to visit. So Christmas morning dawns bright and happy for all. That's a fun little book to check out. We do have it available at the Augusta-Richmond County Public Libraries.
Oh, that's so sweet. Mm-hmm. I have to check that out. That's super cute. Well, speaking of, you know, cute stories and, like, especially classic stories, because I love the classics.
Yes.
The Polar Express.
Yes.
By Chris Van Allsburg. And, you know, I'm pretty sure you've seen, some of you have probably seen the movie, stuff like that, but I just remember having a chance to read this book every year. If you don't know what The Polar Express is about, it's about a young boy. He's lying awake one Christmas Eve and is welcomed aboard a magical train to the North Pole. Mm-hmm. And the Polar Express makes its way to the city atop the world, where the boy will make his Christmas wish. And it's a story for all those who actually believe in the spirit of Christmas and for those who treasure the sound of a reindeer's silver bell. Mm-hmm. It is gorgeously done in movie format, but
yes,
I do love having the book in my hand and reading the book. And maybe that's tradition for you as a book to read on Christmas Eve all curled up.
Yes, I agree 100%. So you have classics like The Polar Express that you just mentioned. And of course, you can't go without mentioning How the Grinch Stole Christmas by Dr. Seuss. Do I even need to give a synopsis on this? Who doesn't know this story?
Just to be fair, just to be sure.
I know. But, you know, you have the Grinch. He has been living his whole life as basically the bah humbug of everything. And he comes across a chance to help Whoville and Whovillians celebrate Christmas. And his heart grows on that day. Boop, 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 boop. Okay? The Grinch, How He Stole Christmas. Really, it should be How the Whoville People Stole the Grinch's Heart. Because after that, he became someone who actually cared for people. But I think it's a nice little Christmas story about celebrating and just embracing people around you and just starting to love. So that's a good story. If you don't know it, definitely check it out. Of course, there's been animated versions of it, where there's the Christmas special that they have for that that comes on every year too. Mm-hmm. Or you can watch a newly animated movie that I think came out just a few years ago.
It's The Grinch. Mm-hmm, so. Or the Jim Carrey one that people love so much. You know,
I forgot about that one. Yes.
Yes, people love that one. But I will say, with The Grinch Stole Christmas, my favorite part was all the antics of him just being like, they down there and they're loud and they're eating all this who ham like, right. and stuff like that. But like you said, it's just really sweet how it pans out in the end. So make sure you check out all of our cute kids, you know, I'm going to say family books.
Yeah.
Because I still read these books as an adult every year. Of course, we're not going to leave you without a YA read. Mm-hmm. So we do have one YA read, and it's The 12 Days of Dash and Lily by Rachel Cohen and David Leviathan. And if those names sound familiar, it's because, you know, they're the writers of Nick and Nora's Infinite Playlist and the book one of this Dash and Lily series, Dash and Lily's Book of Dares. So the synopsis is that Dash and Lily have had a tough year since they first fell in love among the shelves of their favorite bookstore. Lily's beloved grandfather suffers a heart attack, and his difficult road to recovery has taken a major toll on her typically sunny disposition. With only 12 days left until Christmas, Lily's favorite time of year, Dash, Lily's brothers Langston, and their closest friends must take Manhattan by storm to help Lily recapture the unique holiday magic of a glittering, snow-covered New York City in December. So hopefully you will dive in and give that book a chance. The premises is really sweet, and I think it kind of fits the spirit in the moment of the holidays.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. I want to know what it would be like to be in New York during Christmas, like a snow-covered New York. That would be really cool. I've only seen it in pictures because, you know, we're down here in hot Georgia, but... But yeah, I think it'd be really cool to see that during that time.
It would be. I don't really like the cold, so I'm good with the pictures.
Right. Well, speaking of cold and anything Christmas related, you also can check out adult novels that have Christmas themes. But really, you only need to look for one author because she has a whole slew of books on the shelf that take up at least like a whole... 3 or 4 shelves, you know, Debbie McComber. So if you're familiar with Debbie McComber, she writes a lot of contemporary romance novels, but she also writes a lot of Christmas novels. So if you ever go to her section in the library and you see things like Dear Santa, Marianne Bright, or other things that deal with Christmas and all kinds of, you know, holiday themed things, it's because it's Debbie McComber writing the book. So don't be surprised. So if you're looking for something great to read during this holiday season that has the theme of Christmas or the holiday spirit, then look no further. Check out anything by Debbie McComber because she's got something for you. I promise you. Just go over there. You don't even need to know the specific name. You'll find a Christmas book by her. So yes, please check those out.
Awesome.
But yeah, Gina, you know, we were talking about all these things, Christmas and holidays, but what do you like doing during the holidays? Like, what recipes and food do you and your family do? Anything special? Anything you guys like to eat?
So, you guys are going to think I'm the Grinch of Christmas, but I'm not. I really love Christmas, but I don't like decorating, y'all.
Oh.
I don't want to put up the tree. I don't want to do the lights. I don't want to do any of that stuff. Now, I enjoy partaking in those things. Like, I enjoy seeing those things happen. But I am not the one who's just like, oh my gosh. I know some of y'all put y'all Christmas tree up right after the Thanksgiving turkey was taken off of the table.
It's my mama.
I know
my mama.
But I just can't, but I love to see all it. But as far as food goes, for me, some of my favorite things are like sugar cookies. I actually really love like having sugar cookies. This is the real vivid cake time of year.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, so good. Like, and a lot of the same foods that I had for Thanksgiving, I had Christmas, which is, I guess, why I never craved those foods until this time of year.
Yep.
But I like to look at decorations, don't like to put them up. I like to eat tons of Red Velvet cake. Hopefully I can, you know, if I missed out on getting me some pie or something from Thanksgiving, then I can, you know, try to pick that up this year. And movies, like, just like I said last time, like, there's so many movies. My one tradition that I try to do is watch as many versions of A Christmas Carol as possible.
Bless you.
Diva's Christmas. I love that one. I love the OG one, the one Whoopi Goldberg. All of them. Okay. That's what I'm doing.
What are you doing? Your house. Well, I need to come over to your house because I have never seen probably more than just one version of the Christmas Carol. And it probably was the Muppet version. So I know. But the Muppet version was really good.
It really was. We got to fix it, though.
Yep, we gotta fix it.
What do you like to do, Meg, during this time of year? Tell me what you like to do.
Well, I do help with the decorating and things like that. I don't like to do too much of it because I don't like taking it down either. So we just gonna make sure we got a Christmas tree up and some presents underneath and maybe the stockings that hang, you know, over the fireplace. But that's about it. So yeah, there's that. But as far as like food goes, of course, like you said, you kind of get the same foods from Thanksgiving during Christmas. But I like during this time of year that they come out with the gingerbread cookies made by Little Debbie every year. Those are so good. They're so addictive. So we make sure that we buy like at least like 5 boxes of them.
Oh, wow.
Don't eat them all at once. But yeah, buy at least like 5 boxes because they only come out during this time of year. Like you can't find them.
I didn't realize that actually. Now that you said it, it makes sense though.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, that is, yeah. Just get the gingerbread cookies and you're good. Also do like apple pie. I didn't get any pie for Thanksgiving. So I think this year for Christmas, I would like to hopefully have an apple pie. It's not going to be homemade, just so you guys know. more likely, I'm going to get it from the store. So, yeah.
You should try to make it. One year, you should definitely try to make it and see how it turns out.
Yes. If we're still doing this podcast next year, which I hope we are, yes. We'll see. I will let you guys know for sure.
All right. Well, if you want to prepare and get in the Christmas spirit or in the holiday spirit in general, then make sure you come through and enjoy some of our events that's going on. We have things that are holiday themed and things that aren't necessarily holiday themed. But, you know, it's just this wonderful time of year. So the first library event I want to mention is December 4th from 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. There is book clubbing with Misha. You guys remember Misha. We had her on one of our episodes. If you can go back and listen, you know, because we love when y'all listen to our podcast.
Yes, right?
But Misha is having her book clubbing event, and it's a space that's dedicated where people in and around Augusta area in their 20s, 30s, and beyond can come and discuss books and other media. And this month's book is The Vanishing Half by Britt Bennett, which I read and absolutely adore. I don't know if I'm getting a chance to pop in on the session, but I'm really excited about that particular book. But definitely, if you want to get in for more information, if you want to register, then make sure you call. It's 706-821-2627. Or you can sign up at your local library. And also, just know what is discussed in the book session will not be taken out of the book section. The session is not going to be recorded, okay? So enjoy yourself, okay?
Yes. That brings us to, we have another event. This is going to be for young adults at the headquarters library. It's Crafternoon Ornament Decorating. So if you want to make some cool decorations for your tree or at home or just for your house, your room, definitely come out. So all the teens, this is for grades 6 through 12. It's going to be in the headquarters auditorium on December 9th at 4 p.m. So it's perfect for all you kids getting out of school. Just swing by the library. This is actually tomorrow. So if you're listening to this today on the premiere day of our episode, then this will be December 9th, which is going to be tomorrow. And basically they're going to be having some ornament decorating and there might be some light refreshments to help get you in the holiday spirit.
Ooh.
Now registration is required. Please RSVP by calling our YA librarian at 706-434-2036. So please come out for the YA Crafternoon. It's going to be lots of fun.
It sounds tons of fun. I'm actually really excited for what's happening at Applebee,
yes,
which is holiday Riddle Me This.
Mm-hmm.
Riddle Me This. Who can answer new weekly riddles at Applebee or online on the library's Facebook page? Answer you.
Yeah.
So join Applebee each week for new riddles, or go to the library's Facebook page. Mm-hmm. We love to have you there. Yes. So you can enjoy and see if you could crack some of those riddles. I'm going to go look at some of the answers y'all give too.
Yes, yes, for sure. And I must say that I've been to Applebee and those riddles are not easy. Okay, I tried it out the last time I was at that library and I was not even close at all. Nice. So yeah, nice little challenge there. But we're going to have something very exciting also coming up this weekend. So again, if you're listening to this episode on premiere day, December 10th and 11th, we're going to have a book sale at our headquarters library on Telfair Street. So I know it's been a minute, but we got the book sale coming Friday and Saturday. You can join the Friends of the Library for our big book sale of the year. You just come into the library atrium. That's literally when you first walk into the headquarters library. You're going to see them set up with tables. They're going to have deals on all sorts of books and also some multimedia items as well. So, you know, you might find a DVD or two on sale. It might be a movie you've been looking for forever and might be only like, you know, couple cents, couple dollars. So yeah, bring your bags, come out on Friday or Saturday for the book sale. We appreciate all of our patrons coming out and participating.
Awesome. Well, we definitely talked about The Grinch and how it's classic, but you know, maybe you want to like dive into the spirit of Grinch with Grinchmas Party at Wallace Branch Library. So the Wallace Branch Library on Tuesday and Wednesday, respectively, December 14th and December 15th at 1 p.m., will be having a Grinchmas Party. You can enjoy a story time reading of How the Grinch Stole Christmas and a screening of the original film.
Yay!
So you must check out a book to attend the program, and mask and registration are required. And if you want to register, make sure you call 706-722-6275 and go and enjoy the Grinchmas Party at Wallace.
Yes, that sounds like a lot of fun. I've been to Grinchmas parties before, and there's always a lot of cool things that you can do, whether it's making crafts, listening to stories, eating some free holiday food. I'm just saying, you might want to bring your kids. So that leads us to our last event that we're having for our Augusta-Richmond County Public Library system. We have our Dear Kids Mrs. Claus meeting is coming up on December 15th at 11 a.m. for story time. So if you want your kids to meet Mrs. Claus, she is going to ride reindeer all the way down to Augusta, Georgia.
Oh, wow.
That's right. Augusta, Georgia, all the way from the North Pole. Miss Claus is coming here. So you can do a little meet and greet with her. Maybe you take a picture or two. And also listen to a cool little Christmas story. So again, that's going to be on December 15th at 11 a.m. And that's going to be at our headquarters library. So make sure you come down to the headquarters library to meet Mrs. Claus. She's going to be waiting. And she's not going to be here very long because, you know, she's got to get back up to the North Pole before Christmas. So definitely check her out.
Oh, wow. So many amazing programs and books and everything. Well, oh, my goodness. We're here at the end. Well, that's all that we've got for our episode.
Yeah.
And I feel like I'm really ready for the holiday season now.
Me too. We just want to take a moment to thank all of our listeners for an amazing launch and continuation of What's the Fake podcast.
Yeah. And we want to make sure that we're hope to, you know, have you enjoy the content that we've already released and that you also enjoy the content that we will release next year. We look forward to greeting you in February 2022.
Yes. No matter what or how you celebrate, we hope that you enjoy your holidays, continue to enjoy all the wonderful things ARCPLS has to offer, and stay safe until we greet you again. Also, can I just say one more thing here?
Sure.
I always like to mention that you can find us online by going to our website, arcpls.org, and you can follow us on Facebook at arcpls for more information about what's going on in your community, at your libraries, what do we have to offer. not only during the holiday season, but every day of every year. Also, I just want to mention that going into next year, you better look out for some more anime, because we didn't mention that the whole episode.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We did not.
But next year, there shall be anime and manga and more.
That's right. That's right. Until then, of course, we are Meg and
Gina,
wishing you a happy holiday season.
Happy holidays!
Bye!
Thank you for listening. Tune in for new episodes every second and fourth Wednesday of the month. If you like hanging with your friendly, nerdy librarians, follow our library on Facebook at ARCPLS or on Instagram and Twitter at AugustaGALib. Like we always say, we've got the fit, so stick with us.